So we've come over here, like the snails, moving over in the summertime to the fence lines and moving up onto posts, as people have usually seen, to maintain their moisture over summer. The farmer's done a really great job along here of getting rid of all that plant material that they can hang out on. So we've actually come over here to do some sampling to see how many is over here that are still alive. So we can take our standard 30 by 30 centimetre quadrat we're using out in the crop and pop it down. But gee, there's an awful lot of snails there. I don't want to count all them. And if I'm following the Basham, Bate and Burnham book and I'm actually doing 20 of these quadrats, that's a lot of work. So we'll introduce the idea here of subsampling. So the idea is if you've got a population that you can get along fence lines of 6,000 per square metre, that's an awful lot of snails to count. So you might consider using something a lot smaller. So here, I'm using this quadrat here that's about half the size. So I pop that down. I've got 7 dead snails, but I have got a live snail over this side here. So maybe more representative is actually using a bigger quadrat like that. The thing is originally sampling protocols were developed using a standard size, but as long as you're doing something that's representative of your snail population, you can use any size you like as long as you record it. So I think subsampling is a really good tool that you can include in when you're snail sampling and you're doing your 20 quadrats. You just vary the size so you're not counting 1,000 snails per quadrat. Good tip for you guys.